Okay, what's up, my Pulled Up Conversations? Before anything gets recorded, I do not own any copyrights to any of this music. It's not mine. It's just playing in the background, okay? So, how was y'all's Wednesday? I hope that it was great and prosperous and everything went according to your plans and how you made them. To work according to your destiny. And what it is exactly that you want to manifest. So, in my journeys, I always do self-checks. It's not for people to know what I self-check, but I do self-checks all the time. I check myself to see if I was wrong, if I was right. What I can do to improve myself, what I can do to make it better, what I can do to speak better or to make myself come off in a better aspect than what I do. So, in the midst of doing this, I went out and had a good time for the first time in a good little while. Just to let my hair down. My birthday is coming up in like 2 weeks. You know, it's just time to let down. And I went with somebody I was supposed to go with because it's their birthday. So, whatever. It doesn't matter to you who they are. I know who they are and that's all that matters. But after going out and having a good time, I ended up coming back home or whatever. And when I came back home, my neighbors stopped me outside. And it was like, Trace, what is it? And I was like, what? Then it's like, because you don't seem like yourself. You haven't seemed like yourself lately. I'm like, I'm just more driven and more focused on my career and my passion and my dream to get it up and started. Like, what are you talking about? It's like, do you know what it means to live under other people's expectations? I was like, yeah, I know what it means to live under other people's expectations. Because when you live under other people's expectations, you lose yourself. So, and them asking me this, I had to ask myself this again. Am I losing myself in other people's expectations? Am I losing myself in the doubts that other people have against me? Am I losing myself in society, period? And truth be told, at moments I do lose myself. I think at all moments we lose ourselves. I think at all moments or everything that we're going through, we second guess what we're doing because we want to know if it's the right thing that we're doing. You know what I mean? Like, we don't want to put all into a situation to be the wrong thing to do versus the right thing to do. My lash is all kicked up right now, so please excuse it because it's about to come off. I really need to take it off now, but I don't want to take it off because I'm in the video. But, like, in all actuality, all of us go through this crisis in life to try to figure out if what we're doing is right or if we're doing this wrong. But the question is honestly, do you feel like it's right for you or do you feel like it's wrong for you? Do you feel like it fits your life or you feel like it don't fit your life? Because when you're traveling on that spiritual journey in that right path, you're gonna have those situations that make you question or have a concern to it. But at the end of the day, if you're doing the right thing, it's going to say, keep going. If you're doing the wrong thing, it's going to say, no, stop here. It's going to be a flat line. It's going to dead the situation by itself. It's going to... That's it. So, find your true happiness. Find your divine happiness. Don't look for nobody else's happiness. Don't look for your mama's happiness. Don't look for your daddy happiness, your cousin, your sister, your brother. Don't look to fulfill nobody else's life but your own. Because if you're trying to fulfill other people's life, you're neglecting your life. So don't do that. Do yourself justice. And just loving your truth. Be okay with your truth. Who can be mad at you for your truth? Like, come on, y'all. Who can be mad at you for your truth? If you mad at me for my truth, then you's a fucked up individual. You can't beat your truth into me. That's another word for slavery. Okay. I might take this lash off because it's aggravating the hell out of me. And I'm scared to take it out because it's going to pull off my whole eye. Oh, I got it. Okay. And lose my eyelash. Okay. I'm still pretty without it. It's fucked up shit. Whew. I feel so much better. I don't like snuffle up against no more. But my eyelashes are still there. I don't like a plucked chicken. I still got pretty long eyelashes. So don't do me. So don't play me. Don't come for me. I just tripping y'all. But yeah. I still got long eyelashes. Heartbreak anniversary. I'll clean it up later. But love y'all to life. And don't forget, like, just be true to yourself. Okay?